All right, so I was at a speaking actually at a local real estate investor meetup or group to about 60 individuals last night, and as expected, a lot of questions came up, from new investors, and they really all boil down to, either analysis paralysis, or the flip side of that is how do you know when you're ready? So I had a fairly long drive home, probably about an hour and 15 minutes, so I thought I would just brainstorm what a top 10 list would look like. To know that when you're ready to be a buy and hold real estate investor. Because I don't think there's any question. I think you need to do some homework. I think you just can't jump into this thing and make good investments and things of that nature. So I created this top 10 list. If you are a buy and hold real estate investor, do me a favor, look at this and tell me what you think. If you are new to this and you're kind of in that sort of phase, analysis paralysis, my gut says, you should be able to answer at least 9 out of these 10 before you're ready. And then, very quickly know who you could go to answer the 10th question. If you're answering like half or less, you have some work to do, right? I don't think these 10 questions are particularly hard. And I've sort of organized them at each facet of the business, right? From looking at deals to executing deals to managing deals to actually managing units. So, love to hear what you guys think. Let's go ahead and get started with that top 10 list. So first, before we get started, I don't do this a lot, but if you haven't subscribed, please do that for me. It does mean a lot to the channel. We're trying to get to 3,000, I think it is, by the end of the year, and I need some help to get there. So just go ahead and hit that little red subscribe button. It would be great. Like button, especially like buttons earlier in the videos, I hear are good things. So I'll ask you to hit that little like button or thumbs up right now. It would be great. And then finally, comments. Comments are always good, but don't forget this channel has a section called subscriber questions. And if you have a subscriber question, just leave it in a comment and I will do my best to answer it in the next 48 hours or so. So with that, let's get started. So how do you know you're ready to be a real estate investor? And this is specifically buy and hold. Question number one, do you know what the average 3-bedroom, 1-bath, or 3-bedroom, 2-bath costs in your farm area? So these are just basic house structures. I think everyone should have at least a general feel. I will give the caveat that you can focus on your farm area. This is the area that you've decided to speak, put your energy. It doesn't have to be an entire market. It's a subset of a market. So, do you know what the average 3-bedroom, 1-bath, average 3-bedroom, 2-bath costs? I think that's where you start, right? You should know that off the top of your head. And they know it doesn't have to be exact, but it should be within, 5 to 10 grand pretty easily. The flip side of that is this business of buy and hold is really not about the cost, right? Or the purchase price, at least not all that much. It's more about the rent, right? So do you know what a 3-bedroom, 1-bath rents for, or maybe what a 3-bedroom, 2-bath rents for? That's the real question, right? Do you know, does a 3-1 rent for about 1,100, and does a 3-2 rent for 1,300? You should be able to rattle those off pretty close. And again, there are always, exceptions. Doesn't have a 2-car garage, is it street parking, all of that stuff. But again, this is about being close and knowing whether or not you're ready. You have the numbers for at least 3 property managers, or you've already done your due diligence and you know who your property management team is, right? It's hard to do, be a buy and hold investor, especially doing this part-time, without knowing and vetting a property management team. So do you know who that is? Right? Or do you have the name of 3 and you're doing references and asking questions and things of that nature? Do you know what it costs to paint the inside and outside? This may be the one question that you may not think about, but as a buy and hold landlord, the most expensive, part of this business, and the one that gets you each year, is tenant turnover. So one of the things you're going to have to get comfortable for are base expenditures, and one of those is painting a house. Right, when tenants turn, especially if they've been there a while, you will have to pay to get it painted. So this is one I always ask, hey, do you know, right? Does it cost between, $1,000 and $1,300 to paint the inside? Is it, between $2,000 and $2,500 to paint the outside? What is that for you? And then lastly, a sad part of this business is on occasion you will need to evict someone, right? Do you know what the average cost is? And I would caution you to also ask yourself, what's the average time, right? Is this Texas where you're kind of 3 weeks and less? Is it California where it's 90 days? What is that? Because you are going to have these. It will happen over time. Bad stuff happens. Not everybody does what they say they're going to do. So at least have a general understanding of what that is. And if you don't know, ask people. The other one is kind of on the financing side, right? Doing all this work, doing all this, but not being able to execute, kind of frustrating. So, have you taken the time to get a pre-approval letter? Not a pre-qual, right? Pre-qualification, you know, hey, so and so bank's here, and so and so's a great guy, and or great person, and you know, we're ready to go. No, pre-approval, meaning you filled out a financial form, a balance sheet, income statement. You know, she probably showed tax returns, paychecks, all of that stuff. You know, do you have that, right? Are you really ready to go? Do you have the down payment, right? Right? Do you already have the down payment and some make ready money and maybe a reserve set up, right? How ready are you? Do you know your buying criteria? This is the biggest one for me. And if I only had one question, this would be it. All right, if you're stuck, I would always ask, well, what's your buying criteria? Is it I want 200 bucks a month cash flow minimum net? Is it I want 6% on my money? You know, what is that? That's a big deal, right? So if you don't know that yet, you know, go sit down somewhere, figure it out. Do you have your significant other on board, right? I mean, like 100% on board, because this business will test you. It will test you early. It will test you often. I've told lots of you about the Norris Drive story. The short version is, after a year, we finally found something. We bought it. We moved people in. We did everything right. Credit checks, references, blah, blah, blah. And 2 weeks later, they got divorced, right? Something we could not check for. And it got worse from there. So we basically lost 6 months. We had no rent. We had a $15,000 make ready after we evicted. It was just a horrible situation for our first rental. And I believe it would have kicked most people out of this business. Thankfully, we were on board and ready to go. The good news is, over, you know, the thousands of tenants we've had, we only have two stories like that. It's just a sad thing that happened on our first property. And it goes back to the point that real estate investing will test you. And then lastly, do you know the difference between a bad deal and a great deal? You know, just by looking at the numbers, right? This really tells me you've done your homework, you understand rental rates, you understand return. You may not be able to understand an average versus a good deal with just looking, but the spread between a bad deal and a great deal should be obvious to you. I think if you can do that, you understand your buying criteria, you are on your way. So here's the top 10. How many of these could you answer if you're stuck? I'd love to hear from you. Leave comments below. Just leave a number. It'd be great, right? Did you get 7 out of 10? Did you get, you know, 6? Did you get 10 out of 10? Some of you will, and that's great. You should be really, really confident. If you've watched this and got all 10 right, you are ready to go. If you got 0, you got some work to do, right? And it's okay, right? It's better to know now than make a bad investment and risk everything. So again, leave a comment below. You know, I'd love to hear from you. How many, you know, what's your number? Is it 8, 7, 10? You know, let me know. Oh, and again, I'd be ashamed if I didn't push the book One Rental at a Time. It's actually doing pretty well on Amazon for a self-published release. I do thank all of you for making the purchase. If you haven't yet, please do. It's our story and lots of advice and kind of how to do this well. But if you have purchased it, I would ask you to take 2 minutes and just leave a 5-star review. I'm very happy with all the 27 we have as of this morning, and I read them all the time. It makes me smile, it makes me feel good. And again, these are all the things we're, you know, doing for free. So if you could just take a couple of minutes and leave a 5-star review, I would appreciate it greatly. In the end, just again, subscribe. You know, just one of my little goals I do, try to help you out, try to get to the 3,000 this year. Hit that like button. It does mean a lot. It tells me what kind of content you're looking for. And as always, comments mean a big deal to me. For this one, leave again the number of answers you got right. Hopefully it's 8, 9, or 10 out of 10. And if you have a question, just leave the question and I'll do my best to answer it for you. Have a great day.